I ended up growing up in the outskirts of Paris until I was seven. And then we moved to Tunis for a couple years. Then we moved to Nice for a year. Then we moved to West Lafayette, Indiana, when I was 10. Then we moved back to Paris when I was a freshman in high school. And then we moved back to West Lafayette, Indiana. I always felt a little bit like an outsider, going back and forth between different places. Like, I think I developed this sort of self-reliance. Maybe that's why I became an introvert. My father was a mathematician, so he was a professor. Being a Tunisian in France at the time was not easy. You couldn't have a permanent job as a professor. And being, you know, half French and half Tunisian also at the time, you know, I felt that a little bit. So I never felt like I belonged really either in France or in Tunisia, or even in the US. I came as a 10-year-old, essentially without knowing a word of English. But after 6 months, when you're 10, you know, you become fluent. I think I was always interested in it, in science broadly, not mathematics. That I'm sure I was never interested in mathematics. So at the time, you know, you could buy science kits with stuff in them that today you wouldn't be able to sell. So I got, you know, a chemistry kit and I got a physics kit, and you start learning about hooking circuits together and elements or molecules together to form new things. They change color, you crystallize things. And then I started taking science courses in junior high school. In high school, I had a great chemistry teacher. You know, I want to credit him. I think he made a huge difference. And then when I came to college at Harvard, my freshman chemistry professor was also an amazing professor. So that combination, you know, led me in my path. Because when I came to Harvard, also, I had the same problem of feeling like I was an outsider. But chemistry was something that I liked and I could do and forged ahead, and I really liked physics, so I sort of got into the physics realm a little bit and, you know, became a physical chemist. Then I went to visit MIT, and that was a really great experience. And I was so surprised that there was this other university just down the street. I realized it's a really unique place, and that's where I chose to come. So quantum dots are small nanoparticles made out of semiconductors. They're small enough that when you put an electron in them, that electron no longer behaves like a little particle moving in a circuit, but it behaves like a wave, like a quantum mechanical object. It asks the question, what is this transition between an atom and a bulk material? The discovery of quantum dots happened in the Soviet Union and in the US simultaneously by my postdoc mentor, Lou Spruce, in the early 1980s, and by Alexei Akimov in Leningrad at the time, also late 70s, early 1980s. I went to do a postdoc with Lou Bruce, and that's where I learned about quantum dots as the thing. At the time, the materials property of quantum dots was rather poor. That was my project, basically coming at MIT as an assistant professor. Again, I was an outsider. You know, it was an outsider coming into this field of chemistry, of synthetic chemistry, that I really didn't know much about. We ended up developing a way to make these quantum dots to be of quite high quality enough that we could start to do the basic experiments. Within 5 years of me starting here and making progress in making these new materials, I know it started being clear that there were interesting uses for them beyond studying them for their fundamental properties. It's important to really work on what you want to work on, what you believe in, and to have the confidence that if you think it's interesting, then it is interesting. MIT is a great environment. It's very collegial, very collaborative, and the setup of the buildings really encourage that. The interdisciplinarity is really important and unique. It helped to advance my career, make it more rewarding for me because I'm constantly learning new things, and the field itself really benefited from that. Not only is MIT a unique place because of this interdisciplinary, but as a result, we also have amazing students. I couldn't have done my first 3 years here, and which eventually got me a Nobel Prize, without having really bold, smart, and adventurous graduate students it's not just the physical environment, but it's also the people